welcome to my final presentation. My name is Jessica Ramirez. I am from Guayaquil, Ecuador. And today, I'm going to present my final course project. For its elaboration, I chose to work using the label Listen Sketch Strategy. I chose this strategy because I think it is very useful to help students to learn vocabulary. And also because I consider that this strategy allows students to create a picture of words and to check their understanding of those words through interaction. During the last 7 months, I have been learning in this university a lot of techniques, methods, and strategies which are necessary to instruct second learners. I based my research, my project, in some concepts I think are the most important for teachers who want to instruct CLD students. These concepts are the affective filter hypothesis, the communicative approach, Beaks and Kalb's, the stages of second language acquisition, and the grouping configurations. But now I'm going to focus just in one of them, which is the affective filter hypothesis. This is a really meaningful concept for me because it teaches that this concept teaches that it's very hard for students to learn in stressful situations. When students feel scared, their affective filter goes up. This means that it's going to be very difficult for them to acquire a second language. So, students of English are conscious that they make a lot of mistakes when they are acquiring a new language. So, they maybe struggle with the things that they are learning because they think they make a lot of mistakes. In those cases, the role of the teacher is to support them and give them all the help necessary in order to help them to succeed in the learning process. If students feel the support of the teacher, they are going to be willing to learn, and they also are going to acquire the language more easily. Now I would like to start my class. For this, I need to tell you that I'm working with the book number one of the Minister of Education. The unit that I'm working on is the number two, and my class is composed by 42 students. These students are 20 of them in the pre-production stage, 17 in the early production, 5 in the speech emergence, and 1 in the intermediate fluency. So now I'm going to start the class. So I need you please cooperate with me. So good morning, students.
Good morning.
I hope you had a wonderful weekend. Today we're going to learn some vocabulary related to common items at home. But before starting the class, I'm going to present you my content objective, which is that students will learn vocabulary about common items at home to use it in meaningful sentences. I'm going to share with you also our language objectives. For this, I need 4 volunteers to read each of them. Who wants to read? Karina, please.
In a small groups, the students will listen, tell their partners when sharing out the sentence they wrote using the new vocabulary learned.
Who wants to read? Marcus, please.
Speaking, small groups of students will tell their partners about the common items they have at home by sharing out the sentences they quote.
Okay. Wilmer?
Reading. Students will individually read the short sentences they did using all of the words learned through the lesson.
Okay, and Cristobal, please.
Writing. Individually, students will write down sentences and draw pictures that illustrate the meaning of the new vocabulary using the Listen Sketch level strategy.
Okay, thank you, Veronica, also. So, for these class students, We're going to work using this strategy, the listen, sketch, and label. I chose this strategy because it's going to help you to learn vocabulary, and it's going to help us to reach all these objectives. So now I'm going to divide you in groups of three people. For this, I'm going to give each one of you a number. So please listen carefully to it, and when you have your number, you're going to join your partners according to the number I give you, okay?
Okay.
So you are number 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1. So please join your partners, and I will give you the template.
Here,
number 2.
Yeah, we are here, number 3.
Number
3.
I'm going to give you also some color papers that you're going to need to work with this strategy, okay? So now this is what we're going to do. As I told you, we're going to learn some vocabulary. So now I'm going to tell you a word. While I am saying the word, you have to write in your template in this column. In the listen column, you have to write what you think the word means. You can also draw pictures, and you have the colors to the pencil colors to color them. Okay? So do you understand what you're going to do?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to start. I'm going to repeat the word twice. So please listen carefully, and while I'm saying the word, you are writing and drawing. The first word is a skateboard.
Skateboard.
Yes. A skateboard. The second word is MP3 player. Remember that you can do both, write or draw. MP3 player. The third word is video games. Video games. The fourth word is magazines. Remember that you can draw or write. Magazines. Backpack. Backpack. And the last word is rollerblades. Yes, the last word is rollerblades. Did you finish?
Yes.
So now in your small groups, you're going to discuss the words that you wrote or the pictures, okay? You're going to say what you think those words meant, okay? You have to do it now, please. So, okay, this is the way how I would use this template to work with the students in the activation phase. Then, in order to connect their prior knowledge, they are going to think about what they knew before coming to class and what they would learn before the explanation I would give. In order to affirm this knowledge, students are going to write sentences using the words they learn. They also are going to share with their partners their sentences, and they are going to read them also aloud in front of their classmates. To finish this presentation, I would like to say what are the things that I have learned during all this semester. One of the things that I consider is very important for teachers to know is about grouping configurations. This was a very meaningful concept for me because I used to think that students should be only paired with their friends or with the person they like. But during this class, I learned that it's okay to do that. But in many cases, it's better to work to group students with according to their levels, because in this way, they're going to support each other, and they're going to learn from each other, okay? So that was a very meaningful concept for me because I learned as a teacher that we have to be there to support our students' learning process. I also liked a lot the concept I explained at the beginning, which was the affective filter, because I think it's very important to take into account a student's feelings while we are teaching. So we have to let them feel comfortable in the classroom so they can be willing to learn and they lose all the fears they have. So in this way, I'm pretty sure that students are going to progress every day and they're going to be able to produce the English language. So this is what I wanted to share with you. Thank you. Bye.